Crohn's disease is an inflammatory bowel disease that is on the rise globally. In this video, we'll take a look at a young man's journey towards the curing of his Crohn's disease by dietary intervention. A few months ago, a 25-year-old man presented to the gastroenterology department of a major medical center after having suffered from abdominal pain, weight loss, and flu-like symptoms for several months. A few months prior to his presentation, the man had had an abscess in the perianal area, but at this time, he was no longer taking any medications. A colonoscopy was done, and what was found was inflammation and redness and shallow ulcers in the distal part of the small bowel and minimal inflammation in the large bowel. A biopsy done at the time confirmed a diagnosis of Crohn's disease of the small bowel and of the large bowel. The man was started on one of neurobiologicals, infliximab, and after 9 months of therapy, still had not responded. There was no remission. And because of that, the dose of the drug was increased. After a year on infliximab, the man felt a little better, but his Crohn's disease still had not gone into remission. He continued to have bloating and to have fatigue and episodic bouts of severe abdominal pain. Crohn's disease is a form of inflammatory bowel disease that is believed to result from the disruption of the bacteria that live in our bowels, known as the microbiome. This disruption of the bacteria, known as dysbiosis, can cause the immune system in the lining of the bowel to react abnormally, leading to inflammation and the typical signs of Crohn's disease. These symptoms can include abdominal pain, fatigue, fever, bloating, bleeding from the rectum, and this can sometimes progress to perforations in the bowel and fistulas and abscesses in the perianal area or in the abdominal cavity. It is well established that the makeup of our microbiome is heavily influenced by the diet, the foods that we eat. And patients with Crohn's disease instinctively avoid certain foods. The importance of diet in Crohn's disease was confirmed by multiple studies, and this led to the formulation of a number of dietary interventions for the management of Crohn's, such as EEN, or exclusive enteric nutrition, or PEN, or partial enteric nutrition, or CDED, the Crohn's disease exclusion diet. The Crohn's disease exclusion diet is a diet that avoids the consumption of animal products and dairy products and gluten and processed foods and increases the proportion of fiber in the diet by increasing the intake of fruits and vegetables. Crohn's disease is treated by first and foremost inducing remission, which is putting out the fire, getting rid of the inflammation in the bowel wall. Thereafter, it is then maintained by the use of medications and other interventions. The CDED was found to induce remission in up to 70% of patients, particularly those with mild to moderate disease. EEN, or exclusive enteric nutrition, is a dietary intervention in which the patient is fed a special liquid diet for up to 6 to 8 weeks, sometimes as many as 12 weeks, through a tube that is inserted through the nose or the mouth into the stomach without access to any solid food. For obvious reasons, this method of treatment is not very popular, but it was found to be equivalent to corticosteroids in inducing a remission in pediatric patients with new-onset Crohn's disease. PEN, or partial enteric nutrition, is the use of a liquid diet through a tube as described for EEN to provide up to 50% of the daily calorie requirements of the patient, the remainder being provided by a free diet. This mode of therapy, however, was not very effective, although it was better tolerated by Crohn's patients. Current guidelines for the treatment of Crohn's disease recommend EEN, or exclusive enteric nutrition, for the induction of remission in children with new onset Crohn's disease. But apart from Japan, where EEN is used to treat adult Crohn's patients, the use of dietary interventions is barely mentioned in any guidelines for the treatment of adult Crohn's disease. As a matter of fact, the American College of Gastroenterology suggests that dietary manipulation with very close observation was acceptable for the treatment of patients with Crohn's disease with a low risk for progression. After being on infliximab for 2 years and during a period of religious observation for 40 days, during which the man completely eliminated processed foods and animal products from his diet, he experienced complete remission of his symptoms. Prior to that, his diet had been the typical American diet with daily consumption of meat and dairy products and refined grains and processed foods with a few moderate servings of fruit and vegetables. The man completely eliminated processed foods from his diet and limited animal products to one or less servings per week. 6 months later, a follow-up colonoscopy was done, which showed complete healing of the wall of the bowel and no signs of Crohn's disease. 1 year later, because of continued remission, infliximab was stopped. And 10 months after that, the man continued to be completely symptom-free. That whole food diet, which is a diet containing foods found in nature or foods that are only minimally processed, had maintained remission in that man for 10 months. We should, however, remember that we should never alter our treatment regimen for Crohn's disease without first consulting our doctors. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. Support the channel by subscribing, hit the like button, and leave your comments in the section below. Until the next video, stay healthy and stay safe.